Let me show you how to improve AI results using ping pong strategies on the very first try. When it comes to getting better AI results, the old way of prompting is obsolete. That's right, throw it out the window right now. There's a better way to do things without being stuck in a loop of trial and error, trying to get AI to understand what you're asking. No more asking AI a question only to get a response that's completely off base. No more getting stuck in a conversation loop where AI just doesn't seem to understand what you're asking it to do. One of the biggest frustrations with AI is when it doesn't give us the results we're looking for. Sometimes it's because AI is not smart enough, but more often than not, it's because we're stuck in 2024 with our prompting. Ironic, isn't it? That wasn't that long ago. Now, if you want to break free from the kitchen sink prompting cycle and get better results on your next try, it's all about mastering the art of ping-ponging your prompts. And today, my partner Mercer is going to show you exactly how to do it. So let me hand it over to him to show you how this works.
I'm going to create a little Gemini image. I'm just going to say, please, and I'm not going to do power prompting right now. We're just going to take basic prompts. Please tell me 5 different categories for AI prompts. There's a bunch of these. You can create these all the time. They're going to have all sorts of stuff. Here are these different categories we have to go through, right? And it's going to explain it. Then I can say, please give me 10 different types of prompts. And then it goes into, okay, well, here's the different categories of thoughts. Here's these, okay, we have this type, this type, this type. There's chain of thought, there's problem solving, on and on and on. All of this stuff doesn't matter. I thought this stuff mattered a lot. And that is all I really focused on was like, oh, you have to start with this. We have to start telling it. And this is where their trainings are coming from. We have to tell it the role, right? Basically, what the role is, right? What is it supposed to do? Or who is it? What resources should it have, right? What is our desired output, right? So this is the output. And essentially the role is kind of some of your inputs. So we've got the role and we've got, here's what I want you to do. And of course the problem is with this, the what tends to be, you know, the result that we're trying to gain. But if we're using human doing that, we're already teaching how, that's part of the problem. But it really comes down to, here's what the role is you should be doing. Here's what the result is. And then, you know, give the feedback, right? That's the simplest way to prompt. Here's what I need you to, here's who you are. Here's what I want you to do, produce this result. There are lots of other variations of this. I'm not going to necessarily go down those steps because I don't think it's valuable as much as just like me teaching you all the different electron things that happen with electricity is not valuable for you to use electricity. Don't get caught up in the complexity of AI. I think that's what keeps a lot of people from doing it. Basic prompting is very simple. Here's who you are and what I need you to do and the resources you have. Here's the outputs I need you to deliver. Please do that. The only thing that is past this is feedback. This is iteration. And what you're going to see is this is where the power prompting comes in, because normal everyday prompts, you still do this. You give it a role. You say, I need you to do this. I want you to do this. Here's who you are. I want you to do this. Then it gives you the result and you give it feedback. Oh, that's cool. Can you revise this? Can you do that? Can you do whatever the other thing is, right? It kind of does all that sort of stuff. That's the idea. That's as simple as it gets. But that is also what limits AI, right? If we just follow those steps coming from a human perspective, what we're going to do is this power prompting, this ping pong prompting that we're going back and forth to really power up these prompts, is this exact same process. We're going to tell it its role. We're going to give it its result. We're going to ask it for feedback, except we're going to have AI do it. So AI is going to determine its role. AI is going to determine what is necessary for it to deliver. And AI will iterate on itself. AI will give itself its own feedback so that it can improve itself. Right. And get faster. Instead of us going back and forth and iterating, it's going to do it. Collapses time. That's the whole point of AI, is it collapses time so we can get a result faster. We can actually get something that's useful, get it to market faster, improve our own lives faster for whatever the thing is that we're trying to do with AI. All right. So we've got the basics of prompting now. It's basically, here's who you are. Right. And this is kind of, you can start to see where it defines that starting point in its little brain. Here's who you are, the resources you should have. Here's what I need you to produce with those resources. And again, we're kind of teaching it how when we do that as a human. And then it goes for feedback. It'll say, cool, here it is. And then you iterate from there to get to the thing you really want. So that's all we're doing. We're still doing that when we ping pong prompt. Okay. Still doing that when we ping pong prompt. So now we're taking this, instead of us as humans doing that, we're going to first do this as our little human way of doing it, right? So this is our imperfect human way of doing it. Then we're going to have AI, we're going to feed this into AI. So this system kind of will start to look like this. So it'll be, here's what I need you to do. It gets our role, our feedback. And then of this, we're going to give it a super direction here to say, I need you to analyze and then get results and then iterate, right? And I'm just going to call this confirm the result. So we're going to analyze, determine the result that it needs, right? And then we're going to confirm that you've got the result, that you understand this thing. And it's going to do this based on what we gave it, our initial human prompt. That's all we're doing. So we're going to give it our prompt. It's going to then, we're going to tell it to iterate coming through. Now, the way we're going to do that, you've already seen this in the webinar. Make sure everybody has this. I think some of you are already in there, which is awesome. I'm going to put this in chat as well. Come on. There we go. So grab this so everybody has it. And again, those playing along on the recordings, just go to profitschool.com/AI guide. It will always take you to the most current version of this. I'm saying bookmark here, but I mean just I'm just going to save that. Say save, because bookmark I know is like a browser thing, and you can't quite bookmark a redirect. But don't bookmark this. You totally can't. Don't get me wrong. It's just that when we iterate it, we may not. It might be eventually a PDF or something like that. So if you go to profitschool.com/AI guide, it will always go to the most recent useful version of this tool. So that's why we put that in there. Now, we already talked about this on the webinar. AI already knows the how. You understand why it knows the how now, because of how it was built and how it learned everything. Because it learned everything not by understanding what it is, it learned everything by understanding every way that it is not the thing. So it knows so much more about it. That's kind of what it, that's why it can make those connections. Your job is to communicate what you want AI to produce for us, right? And then we're going to define those specific results to get better quality responses using AI's prompt. AI is going to tell us, oh, here's how to do that. We already have these two steps. You're going to use these over and over again. So I'm going to go through this. So with power prompting, how do we do this part is with this prompt. So what I'm going to do here. Oops, there we go. That's what I wanted. Apologies. Let me just organize my brick. I don't know why that wasn't working there. All right, that is not working. Let me just get rid of this. Thought that would be good. That is not working out. Let's do it like this. Okay, at least I have a shape I can change. All right. So the way that this prompt works. When you're coming through here, we're saying analyze the following prompt, right? So we're going to have it analyze the following prompt. That's going to be your human prompt that it's doing. That's the first thing when I started out doing this, and I have iterated this. I'm going to sort of explain how this prompt works, and we'll practice it together. So analyze the following text. You're going to rate your understanding, the desired result, scale of 1 to 10, where 10 is you define what it is that you are looking for. Okay, so I'm just going to give you the recipe for this. So we're analyze the following text. This is always whatever is following. So it knows whether it's a prompt or whatever. It's going to figure out what it is that you are trying to do. You're asking it to rate its understanding always on a scale, and specifically the desired result, right? Always keep that in there. Scale of 1 to 10, where 10 is you fully understand the desired result, right? Now you can define this sometimes, and I'll show you how to do this as we go. But what we're basically saying is keep looking at this until you really understand what it is that you're looking at. It almost never comes in at a 10 out of 10. It almost always understands the stuff that you don't necessarily know that it's got it, that it, or it almost always doesn't understand something, but doesn't always tell you that unless you put this in there. So this is why we say explain your reasoning for the rating. Then rate the understanding on the hidden attention. Now, this is something I've added. This is the other piece. This is where I leveled it up because I added this piece back in there. I wanted it to iterate again. I didn't want it to just understand the desired result that I was trying to get to, though that was still good. That produced amazing results. What I wanted was for it to understand the desired result and then kind of why it thought I wanted that result. In other words, what did it think I was wanting to do with that result? Because if it understands the hidden intention behind the result I'm trying to get, it now knows the problem I'm trying to actually solve. The result is just my idea of what that solution might look like. But when it understands the hidden intention behind my result, it goes, well, I might actually get you a different, like maybe I can give you a different result that'll get you there you know, faster, better, stronger, whatever it is. Because it knows the real problem I have that I'm trying to solve. So if there's a better idea of a desired result that really gets his intention, it can now do that because I'm allowing it to do that. And again, that's why we go through it at a scale of 1 to 10 when it fully understands the entire desired retention, explaining the reasoning. So during this process, this is the iteration part of this. So where it'll say, first it analyzes everything and explains its initial reasoning. Then it's going to go through and it's going to rate yourself 10, list questions, and then have the most useful answers to those questions, right? So that what we're basically saying is, if you didn't rate yourself a 10, which again, it almost never does, it will explain why. What was the thing that it needed that it did not get from you? That's what that is. Then what I'm telling it to do is instead of asking me those questions, because that's just making me do more work, you come up with the answers to the questions, right? You come up with the answers to the questions so that they're useful, right? And this is where we say the most useful answers for those questions. So, and you will see this in thought as it goes through. Then we say, just keep doing this until you have both a 10 out of 10 understanding for the desired result and that intention, that hidden intention behind, in other words, the real problem that I'm trying to solve. Now, as a human, this is very important. This is not just about copying and pasting and copying and pasting and copying and pasting. It is about copying and pasting and then TBVing, trust but verify. You want to go back and you need to be a good manager for your AI team. Just like you would never leave a bunch of humans, just hire a bunch of humans in your team and be like, cool, have at it, make the company bigger and I'll see you in a year. I'm not going to give you any training. I'm never going to check on anything you're doing. And I'm just going to cross my fingers and hope it's going to work. You would never do that with humans. You should never do that with AI ever. But you would manage humans for performance. You just manage AI for performance. That's all this is. So we're just going to become better managers now. And if you don't have a team, you do now, right, with your AI. So congratulations, you're a manager.
Look, we've all been guilty of giving poor prompt instructions or giving too little context and then wondering why AI just doesn't get it. But the truth is that it's not AI's fault. It's our fault for thinking that we alone can give it the right instructions. Ping pong prompting is a secret to taking a bad prompt and turning it into a good one. So don't be afraid to try out different prompts, see what works and what doesn't, and then be willing to adjust your prompts on the fly to get better results. That's exactly how ping pong prompting works. You refine your prompts in real time and you get better AI results from it. So, what are the key takeaways on improving AI results with ping pong prompt techniques? First, be specific and provide context. Second, break down large tasks into smaller and more manageable chunks. And then finally, work with AI to refine your prompts in real time to get better results. Thanks for watching, and I hope you learned something new today. If you're as blown away as I am with ping pong prompts, I'd love to hear about it in the comments below. And if you want to take your AI game to the next level, be sure to check out our Gemini AI workshop over at profitschool.com/Gemini. That's all for this one, and I'll see you in the next video.